There are several ways that Go developers can run apps in the cloud. Azure provides multiple compute services to choose from to meet your app's needs, including web apps and Kubernetes. Josh Gavant is here to show us how to choose which one to use today on Azure Friday. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Azure Friday. I'm Erik St. Martin, and today we have Josh Gavant here with us to talk about all the various ways that you can run your Go applications inside the cloud.
Yeah, thanks, Erik. Great to be here. This is quite an interesting topic. There are so many different ways people can run apps in the cloud, and sometimes it's a little confusing. What's the best for you? Or maybe you know what's best for you, but you need to know what to choose from the cloud that you're running on, like what fits with what you need.
There's a bit of analysis paralysis there, right? Like which is the best way to go?
Yeah, and there's so many terms like Kubernetes, and then you've got PaaSes, and you've got serverless, right? So like what one should you use for what? What do we have in Azure that meets those characteristics and things? So that's what I wanted to talk about today. The options we have, and I'm gonna demonstrate one of them. So I wanted to start with this diagram, this kind of concentric circles, where to kind of orient around what we're talking about. At the very center, the smallest kind of thing you might have is a function or serverless, which is basically a snippet.
There's some small unit of work that does something really, really.
Yeah, I think so, most of the time. And you don't want to have to put up a whole app around. You don't necessarily want an OS and have to worry about configuring the entire process of running that function. So that's nice, function takes care of that for you. And then on the other end, you have a Kubernetes cluster where you've got multiple containers, maybe in several pods interacting to provide a cohesive service. And then somewhere in between, you have what we call app service, which runs web apps. It can run them from source, say. That's kind of what I'm representing with that green circle here. If you've just got a service running straight from source, okay. You can bundle it up into a container. That kind of lets you define the build process a little more, define OS level dependencies, and still run it in that same thing. And then actually beyond that, let's say you're getting ready, you're thinking about maybe you have several containers working together or several candidates for Kubernetes pods working together, then you might consider graduating up to Azure Container Instances or Azure Kubernetes Service. Yeah, so I wanted to focus on let me exit the screen for a moment. We'll leave that in the background. Keep us oriented. So you might not even know this. Azure has a couple services that I wanted to talk about. The web app service, and then the Azure Container Registry. And at first it might not, like what's that have to do with how you run your apps? But the nice thing is that Azure Container Registry actually is also a container builder. It has something called build tasks, which there's a couple things they can listen on. They can listen for a Git commit to like a GitHub repo and then rebuild your container right away. They can even listen for changes to like the layers of the container. Like if the OS image that they're depending on changes, they can actually get notified and update that and rebuild for you too.
Okay, so this is
some pretty cool stuff.
So instead of just pushing your image that you built locally up to ACR, you also have the ability to just push your change Docker file or something to GitHub, and then ACR builds it and also stores it the same way a registry would.
Yeah, exactly. And so this is kind of our most supported story for Go apps right now. I've talked to a lot of customers, and some are like, oh yeah, I start with a Docker file in every repo, but some are like, why should I involve Docker? So at least with this is our most supported story for Go. At least at this, you just need the Docker file. You put it up there once, then you focus on your code thenceforth. And we are looking into, for the future, building straight from source into web apps so you don't have to worry about a container at all. But right now, yes, you put your Docker file up there and then the rest is history. So I just want to, let's open this read-only is fine. What I want to show you, also a little bit of Azure CLI here, I'm going to show you the four or five resources we have to create to kind of set up our build pipeline, and then we're going to go ahead and just run it, and we'll make a change, and then we'll see it pick up that change and reflect it right away.
Awesome.
So yeah, so let me show you the Go app. It's pretty straightforward. I've added some stuff to look for the port environment variable because I know app service looks for it. But then basically I'm just listening for a request and then returning hello. Pretty straightforward. The script, let's just say open read only. I must have it open somewhere else. Or a swap file open. So I'm not going to focus on all the script, but I just want to show a few salient points. And the CLI really can do all of this stuff for you. You sometimes got to figure out exactly how to make it work, but it can do a lot of cool stuff for you. So first I check to make sure that I have a registry available. And the best way to do that, if you need to create one, is azacr-create. I make sure that I get out the credentials and things that I'm going to need later on so that I can configure the registry to talk to web apps and, yeah, to talk to web apps, actually. The next thing I have to do is create an app service plan, which I do with AZ app service plan create. A plan and app service kind of lets you run multiple web apps or multiple function apps all under the same umbrella. It's kind of similar to a resource group at the Azure level.
OK, so it's more of a grouping than a pipeline or something. It's just kind of like a namespace.
Yeah, although I think some features might be set at the plan level, I think. So after we have a plan, then we can go ahead and create a web app. Which here on line 116 is AZ web app create. If you were creating a function app, it would be AZ function app create. You'll notice that I pointed at the container image that I want it to load. And then that's actually the next lines here. I tell it where to look for the container that I'm gonna have continuously deploying from the container registry into app service. And then finally, I'll show you a couple things, actually. So I have a couple things. One of them is azacr build. And that's another interesting. You could do Docker build and, azacr build does the equivalent of Docker build, but in the cloud. So okay. That's one way to run a one-off task. And then you can do azacr build task create, and that actually allows you to specify. You'll notice here on line 177, commit trigger enabled.
Okay. And that's what tells it. Just to monitor GitHub and basically trigger the equivalent of the ACR build every time it sees a new commit.
Yep, okay. Exactly. So I think that is it. And then I curl at the bottom. So now if I would run setup.sh, it would deploy all those resources for me, set up the container build. I've actually done that all, luckily. So let's just look at the result. So we're opening up the portal. I'll show you how it looks in the portal. Let's find the group we created. So this one is the one that's in build right now, I believe. Yeah, so you see it's currently building up my sample registry. But here's one I've built earlier, Go Tester 2 group. So resource groups are also kind of a containerizing mechanism, not that kind of container. in Azure to kind of group resources together. You can grant authorization rights based on a resource group. You can manage them more cohesively. So I put all these things into one resource group. You see I've got my registry there. Tells me all kinds of things that I'm doing. I can look at the repositories. You'll see the one that I just pushed is here. I'm actually not sure if build tasks are listed in the portal. You might have to go through the CLI to see all that. And then I have my web app, which it's spun up. And I should be able to hopefully go here. And it says, hello, blank. We know that if we add in name equals, let's say hi to you. I always say hi to myself. Hello, Eric. So the basics work. If I wanted to now, let's go over here and create a new window and CD back into that repo. Josh Gav go sample. And I wanted to make a change to that code, so let's just go into main.go. This is a little risky because it definitely takes a minute or two. I made a change. And we should be able to, let's check on our, what did I change in setup? Oh, well, okay, just that one, I'm just going to change that one file, so git add main.go. And git commit, here's a change. And git push, go. Oh, looks like my token has expired. That's not so good.
Live demos.
Yes. I know what I can do. Just give me one. Well, I'll change the token right away after. How about we do it that way? So to get a new token, Jesus. Settings, GitHub, settings, tokens. Okay, let's go ahead and generate a new one. Regenerate, copy. Please do your best not to look, but I'm going to change it. And then
everybody else gets to deploy out to your builder.
Git push. What happened there? Git push. Yeah, exactly. Everyone else can use this now, too. OK, cool. So I pushed it out there. It sometimes takes a couple seconds to run, but now it should be, we should be able to see that in a second. A couple other interesting things now that we have our container registry here, you'll notice, I'll just jump in there back to that image real quick. If I go to the repos, I think it's here. Run instance, deploy to web app. There are some things here that can, actually this is probably the most interesting one. Like now that I'm in the container registry, it's just one small step to start using ACI instead of web apps. Of course, okay. I might need to change the architecture of my app a little, especially making sure that it's totally not stateless and things. But we've actually considered that. Like, hey, container registry is good for deploying to web apps. It's also good for deploying to
Now, what's the advantage ACI? To using something like web apps versus ACI?
There's a lot of extra value there. Like there's authentication services that they'll run in front of it for you. They automatically track some HTTP requests and things, so some performance monitoring. They can scale. They can set up scaling rules for you so you scale out as long as you've architected this the right way. A couple benefits of web apps that we're not totally able to realize in Go yet. Is these inner two things. Sorry, it's a little small. These inner two, so the function, which is pure source, and then the app without a container, the service without a container, which is also pure source. Those things are coming soon. We actually have them in private internal preview right now, but if people are interested, they should reach out to us, and we definitely would like some feedback on the way we're doing those inner, less, no container involved.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah. So, so you got a range of compute services on Azure, all the way down from functions and snippets, all the way up to Kubernetes and apps and clusters. And you can choose the right ones, and we'll help you run your apps.
Thanks so much. I mean, this is great. I mean, I didn't even realize that ACR had builders built into it.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, actually, let's see if our app has been updated. Ah, cool, so it's working now. I lost your name, but there we are. Name equals Eric, and our change came through. I'm really happy that that actually worked.
That's awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining us, Josh. So today on Azure Friday, we were learning about all the various ways that Go developers can run their applications in the cloud.